Myself Richa Singh. I will teach you class 12th physics lesson number 9 ray optics. In previous class you have studied the laws of refraction, the principle of reversibility and so much more. Now today we will see the practical application, some of the practical application of refraction. Okay, so this topic is very important because based upon this topic, one practical is also there, one experiment is also there. So see here, the real and apparent depth. First of all, we will see the meaning of real and apparent depth. As we have seen in our common experience, if any object is placed in a tank which is filled with water, then object is appear to raise. That means जो object की height है वो हमको छोटी दिखाई देती है. That means image of object जो हम ऊपर से देख रहे हैं वो हमको छोटी दिखाई देती है. और जो छोटी image दिखाई दे रही है that is called apparent depth. और जो apparent depth है उसको हम Snell's law की help से we can also calculate. Okay, so first of all, for calculating the apparent depth, here we will see the figure. Here I have taken the denser medium, suppose water, and in this denser medium water, an object is kept at the point O. Okay, and after refraction, see, I have considered two rays of light, AO and OB. And after refraction, this will bend away from the normal because ray of light is bending away from the normal. It is passing from denser medium to rarer medium. This ray after refraction, suppose this is the path BC and suppose this is the path AD. Okay. Now by the help of Snell's law, so after refraction OB ray passes through BC and the AO ray, it is normal ray, so the path of this ray will not change, it will pass through AD. Okay, and if we extend this ray BC in backward direction, so it forms the it appears to diverge from this point I. That means it appears to diverge from IB. Okay, so the actual height of the object, because the object is kept at the point O, so the actual height of the object is, that is HO. Okay, and the apparent height that we are observing from the upper side, from the this point, the apparent height of the object, that is HI. And now we will see the relationship between height of the image and height of the object, that is real depth and the apparent depth. By using the Snell's law, as we are knowing that by using Snell's law, water mu glass, water mu air, see the ray is passing from water to air, so we will write water mu glass is equal to sin I upon sin r. Okay, see here, this is angle of incidence and this is angle of refraction. See here, actually we have drawn the normal and this is angle of refraction, and we know the property of corresponding angle. If this angle is angle of refraction, then this angle will also be angle of refraction. Okay, so sin I upon sin r. Now we will calculate the value of sin I by the angle. See here in this figure, sin I is equal to angle AOB, so we will write sin of angle AOB upon sine of angle AIB. angle AIB. Now students, we are knowing sine theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So angle AOB is equal to perpendicular, that is AB, upon hypotenuse, that is OB. And sine AIB, here again perpendicular AB upon hypotenuse BI. Okay, AB and AB will be cancelled. The remaining values will be equal to BI upon OB. Okay, but for observing the image of the object, because the size of our pupil is very small, so this point will be closer to the point A. So that here we will consider that is BI will be nearly equal to this. BI will be nearly equal to AI, and this OB is nearly equal to AO. Okay, so in place of BI we will write AI, upon in place of OB we will write AO. Okay, that is equal to water mu glass, and we know the relation, reciprocal relation. Water mu glass is equal to 1 upon air mu water. Okay, or we can write air mu water is equal to what? AO upon AI. We have done just reciprocal. Now AO is the real depth. So refractive index is equal to real depth upon AI is the apparent depth. AI is the apparent depth. Okay? Or we can write real depth, that is equal to HO upon HI is equal to the refractive index of the denser medium with respect to rarer medium. Understood? So by this formula we can calculate the apparent depth. So apparent depth, that is HI, is equal to HO upon refractive index mu. Okay? Understood? Now I will ask one numerical based upon this formula. Suppose the height of the object, that is HO, is given 2.8 centimeter. Height of the object is given 2.8 centimeter, and the refractive index of water that we are knowing, that is 1.33. So what will be the apparent height, that is HI? So by using this formula, the apparent height, that is HI, will be equal to HO upon mu. And what is equal to HO? That is 2.8 centimeter upon refractive index, that is 1.33, that is of water. So we can calculate the height of the image by putting this value. Okay, it will be approximately 1 point something centimeter. Okay, we will see the special case of refraction. The special case is the total internal reflection. Okay, so we will see the meaning of this total internal reflection. Student, as we are knowing that when a ray of light passes from denser medium to the rarer medium, some part of the light get reflected and some part of the light get refracted. But if we change the angle of incidence, then at a particular angle of incidence, the entire part of the light get reflected back into the same medium. This is called the total internal reflection. So for understanding, first of all we will see this figure. Here I have considered three rays, rays 1, 2 and 3. All these rays are passing from denser medium to the rarer medium. See the first case, the ray, first ray, it is passing from denser medium to the so see here, when a ray of light passing from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. And as we are increasing the angle of incidence, then what happens? The angle of refraction will become 90 degree. And if the angle of refraction will become 90 degree, then this particular angle of incidence is called the critical angle. And we can represent by this by IC. Okay? And if we increase the angle of incidence more than critical angle, that means I is greater than IC, then what happens? The ray of light will totally internally reflected. The ray of light totally internally reflected. Okay? And this phenomenon is called total internal reflection. Okay, so again we will see the definition of critical angle as well as the total internal reflection. So the angle of incidence in the denser medium for which the angle of refraction in the rarer medium will become 90 degree. This particular angle of incidence is called angle critical angle, and it is represented by IC. Okay, now we will define the total internal reflection. So the phenomenon in which a ray of light traveling at an angle greater than critical angle from denser medium to the rarer medium is totally reflected back into the denser medium, it is called total internal reflection. Understood? Now the students, you have to keep it in mind, there are two necessary conditions for the total internal reflection. So many times when this topic is asked in board exam, what do you mean by total internal reflection, they ask these two necessary conditions. So what is the first necessary condition? When the light is passing from denser medium to the rarer medium, first condition is that the light will always pass from optically denser medium to the optically rarer medium. And the second condition is that always the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. See the third condition, angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. Okay, now we will come to the relation between angle, critical angle and refractive index. Okay, so by using the Snell's law, again we will use the Snell's law, the refractive index, the ray of light passing from denser medium, suppose here we have considered denser medium by 2 and the rarer medium by 1. So the ray of light is passing from denser medium to the rarer medium, 2 mu 1, that is again equal to sin I upon sin r, okay, by Snell's law. And at the time of critical angle, when angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, then angle of refraction will equal to what? That is equal to 90 degree. Okay, put both the values, then we will write 2 mu 1, we can also write it is equal to 1 upon 1 mu 2, okay, by principle of reciprocity. So it is equal to sin, in place of I we will write sin IC upon sin R, and in place of sin R we will write sin 90, okay? So that is 1 mu 2 is equal to sin 90, that is equal to 1 upon sin IC. Okay? So what is the relation between the critical angle and refractive index? That is 1 mu 2 is equal to 1 upon sin IC. Okay? So we can say that refractive index is reciprocal of sine of critical angle. As the critical angle, sine of critical angle is more, then the refractive index will be less. Understood? Now we will see the other application of refraction. How does the refraction of light affect the length of the day? Okay? This is also very good example why we are able to see the position of sun before sunrise, and we are able to see the position of sun after sunset. Okay? So this is the actual cause of before sunrise. The position of sun we are able to see, and after sunset also we are able to see the position of sun. The actual cause is the atmospheric refraction. Okay, so see here, if the actual position of the sun is here and the observer is here, okay, as we go away from the earth, as we know that the density of air will decreases, and as the density of air decreases, the refractive index will also decreases. So when the ray of light passes from sun towards earth, then it bends towards the normal, because it is coming from rarer medium to denser medium, and so many times it bends towards the normal. So if we extend the position of this ray, then the apparent position of the sun will not be S, if the apparent position of the sun will be S dash. And this apparent position, due to this apparent position, we are able to see the sunrise before 2 minutes. In the same way, we are able to see the sunset after 2 minutes also. Okay? Now we will see various application of total internal reflection. Okay, so first application is the sparkling of diamond. Why the diamond sparkle a lot? Student, because the refractive index of diamond is very much more, that is 2.42, and as the refractive index of diamond is more, then the critical angle will be less. So as the ray of light enters in diamond, then due to small critical angle, the ray of light totally internally reflected so many times. That's why the diamond sparkle more. So student, हमने अभी देखा कि डायमंड जो है वो किस तरीके से इतना ज्यादा चमकता है, क्योंकि उसमें एक बार रे ऑफ लाइट अगर एंटर हो जाती है तो सो मेनी टाइम्स उसमें अंदर ही अंदर इतनी बार रिफ्लेक्शन होता है, जिसके कारण डायमंड इतनी अच्छे से चमकता है. अब सी द सेकंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन, दैट इज मिराज फॉर्मेशन. स्टूडेंट्स अक्सर ये गर्मी के सीजन में हमको मिराज फॉर्मेशन का जो एग्जाम्पल है वो देखने को मिलता है. अगर हम रोड पर जाते हैं तो सामने हमको क्या दिखाई देता है, ऐसा लगता है कि रोड पर पानी है, बट एक्चुअली में पानी नहीं होता है. तो ऐसा क्यों होता है, देखिए, अगर हम एक्चुअली में ज्यादातर गर्मी के सीजन में जो हमारी अर्थ है वो बहुत ज्यादा गर्म हो जाती है, और जैसे जैसे अर्थ की लेयर में हम ऊपर ऊपर की ओर जाएंगे तो जो लेयर ऑफ एयर है वो डेंसर होती जाएगी. ठीक है, इसके लिए हम एक एग्जांपल लेते हैं ट्री का. अगर ट्री के से रे ऑफ लाइट आएगी, इट विल पास फ्रॉम denser medium to the rarer medium, and if the ray of light passes from denser medium to the rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. And a situation will come when then the angle of incidence will become will more than the angle of critical angle, and at that time the ray of light will get totally internally reflected in the same medium, and we will see the image of this tree here. Okay, so we just think that on the road there is water. Okay, the third application is totally reflecting prism. Here one prism I have drawn. This prism is a special prism having two faces, 45 degree, and one face is 90 degree. See here. And suppose an object is kept here in front of the slanting side. Okay, this object AB, and the ray of light incident on the face AB, then it reflect back by making the 90 degree angle. So this application of total internal reflecting prism we are using in periscope. Okay, then the very famous application of total internal reflection is optical fiber. Nowadays we are using optical fiber for communication, for fabrication, for making so many lighting instrument. ठीक है, तो देखिए उसमें optical fiber में total internal reflection का किस तरीके से use करते हैं. Mainly जो हम हमारा optical fiber इतना पतला जो optical fiber होता है उसमें जो कोर होता है उसका रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स जो बाहर की हम कोटिंग करते हैं दैट इज कॉल्ड क्लैडिंग. तो द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ कोर इज ऑलवेज मोर देन क्लैडिंग. जो बाहर का जो कोटिंग है उसको हम क्लैडिंग बोलते हैं. तो ये वाली कंडीशन अगर हम रखेंगे दैट इज म्यू वन इज ग्रेटर देन म्यू टू, देन व्हेन अ रे ऑफ लाइट एंटर्स इनसाइड द ऑप्टिकल फाइबर, then because of refractive high refractive index of inside surface, the ray of light get totally internally reflected so many times, and the clear and bright image of the object which is kept here we is obtained on the other side. So various interesting application of total internal reflection are there. Student, you just read in your book and make the notes on total internal reflection. Okay.